welcome back. Today's video is going to be a tutorial on the look I'm wearing right now. I decided to finally create a tutorial using green eyeshadow. Personally, I love green eyeshadow. I think it complements brown eyes beautifully and I just love wearing green eyeshadows on my eyelids. Whenever I play around with green eyeshadows, I always like the results. So I decided to finally create a green makeup look. So if you're interested in knowing how to get this look, then just keep on watching.
So to start off today's look, I already applied my primer and then I'm going in with a mixture of my Marc Jacobs Remarkable Full Coverage Foundation and also my IT Cosmetics CC Plus Cream. And as you can see, I'm running out of my IT Cosmetics CC Plus Cream, but luckily I have a backup. And then I'm going to apply them using my Damn Beauty Blender. For concealer, I use the Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer and I'm going to apply this underneath my eyes but also on the center of my face to balance everything out. And then I'm using the Makeup Revolution Ultra Contour Palette and I'm going to use the lightest banana shade to set underneath my eyes and also all the other areas where I applied my concealer. Then to set the rest of my face in place, I'm going to use the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Pores Pressed Translucent Powder. Then to fill in my eyebrows, I use the ColourPop Brow Pencil in Dope Dope. And as always, I'm going to speed through this because you have seen me do this 100 times already. And then to set my brows in place, I went in with the Essence Make Me Brow Eyebrow Gel. Then moving on to the eyes, I'm first going to prime them using the Milani Eyeshadow Primer. Then to make sure everything will blend smoothly, I am going to set the eyeshadow primer using Makeup Geek's Vanilla Bean eyeshadow. Then I decided I wanted a sharp line for today's look, so I'm going to apply some tape on the outer corners of my eyes. And then I'm going in with the shade Creme Brulee, also by Makeup Geek, and this is going to be my transition shade. So first I'm going to apply this in my crease, and then I'm going to fade it out towards my brow bone, where my brush has a little bit less product on it. Then to darken things up a little bit more, I'm going in with the shade Frappe, also by Makeup Geek. So I'm going to apply this in my crease, just below the transition shade. Then I used the previous brush without any additional product to blend everything out. Then I went in with the shade Cocoa Bear, and this is going to go right into my crease. So I'm going to pack it in there and then blend it out using a clean blending brush. And as you can see, I was out of focus, so I'm sorry about that, but I didn't notice when I was filming. But I'm going to repeat this process, add a little bit more of Cocoa Bear, blend it out until I am happy with how it looks and how intense it is. Then I'm using the shade Venom, and this is going on my eyelids where I didn't apply any other eyeshadow, and this is just going to bring everything together. Then I made sure there were no hard edges using the previous brush with, again, no additional product. Then I decided to darken up my outer V using Americano, so I'm going to apply it on my own V and then blend it out. And to highlight my inner corners, I decided to go in with the shade Charmed. This is a foiled eyeshadow by Makeup Geek, and I'm going to apply it on my inner corners and drag it in just a little bit, and then I'm going to blend it out using the Venom brush without any additional product. And then to make sure there were really no harsh edges, I went in with the shade Frappe just a little bit on a tiny brush and made sure I blended out the edges. Then I'm going in with the shade Vanilla Bean again to highlight my brow bone. Then it was time to remove the tape, and then I decided to clean everything up using a little bit of concealer. Next, I packed on Americano on my lower lash line. Then I decided to add some green eyeliner onto my waterline. This one is by Essence. I think it was a limited edition one. And then I'm going to blend everything out using Creme Brulee by Makeup Geek. Then it was time to finish off the face, so I'm going to use my Makeup Revolution Ultra Contour Palette, and I'm going to use the contour shade to contour my cheekbones. Then to add some bronzer to my face, I decided to go with my favorite one, and this is the Too Faced Sweethearts Bronzer in Sweet Tea. For blush, I used the De Balm Desert Bronzer / Blush, so you can use it as a blush or as a bronzer, but I prefer to use it as a blush. Then to add some highlight to my face, I used the Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit in Gleam. I used the two bright shades. Then to make sure my makeup will stay in place and don't move throughout the day, I use the Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray. Then I curl my eyelashes, and then it was time to add some mascara. Today I used the Essence and Catrice one, the newest one by Essence and Catrice, which I talked all about in my What's New at the Drugstore video. Then for lips today, I decided to go in with something that's a little bit more on the nude side. So I decided to use the Kylie Cosmetics Lip Kit in the shade Malibu. So I'm going to use the lip liner first and then top it all up with her liquid lipstick. We'll be right back.
So that wraps up this makeup tutorial. I really hope you enjoyed it. For me, this is one of my favorite tutorials I've done so far. I love this look. As I mentioned in the beginning of the video, this is one of my favorite looks to create, so I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did making it. If you did enjoy it, then definitely give it a thumbs up. You can also follow my social media and blog, which is linked down below. And yeah, if you haven't already, then just subscribe to my channel because it will mean the world to me, and I hope I will see you in my next video. Bye guys! We'll be right back.